No, that wasn't the stipulation. Okay, if you can't get last year's receipts to me today, I'll subpoena your records from 65 on so that my office can do the math. Thank you. I'll expect the documents by 5.
That was smooth. The Reinstein verdict will be in this afternoon. Your deposition is at 2. They insisted on using their court reporter. Here are your tickets to the Philharmonic. Hello?
Hello.
Oh, and cancel lunch with Judge Miller. What?
It's your mother.
Mama?
Renee, honey, it's about Daddy.
Renee?
Renee, baby, come on. I want you to get washed for dinner.
Okay.
Son, take that hat off before we start eating.
Don't like you on these back roads at night, James.
I'll be in Atlanta before you finish the dishes, baby.
I don't know why you can't go in the morning.
Honey, we've been through this before. I have to go because we need to regroup. We can't afford to make the same mistakes we made in Albany.
But you're not the only attorney in the South, you know.
No, but I'm the handsomest. Oh, I hear you girls are going bra shopping tomorrow.
Mother!
Yes, Mom, I'll be there as soon as I can. I love you too, Mama. Bye.
I wish I could go.
You can. Make a few calls, pack a bag.
Renee, I haven't even started grading finals. I got a lecture tomorrow night at the Smithsonian. I only met him once.
Him? My father.
Yeah, I know, baby. It's just, I don't belong there. Not your family, your friends.
But if we have a life together, they're your friends and your family, too.
I'll drive you to the airport.
No. Not unless you're getting on that plane with me. I'll call you from Birmingham.
And it's going to be another beautiful day here in Birmingham. All across the South, as a matter of fact, with eyes and
got your happy meal. You remember Renee Jackson?
Whoa, that's a blast from the past.
Her father died. Bet she's coming home for the funeral.
So?
So she was my best friend, Collier.
About a million years ago.
Nothing wrong with me paying respects at the funeral.
After what she did to you?
We were 19 years old. I wasn't exactly an innocent bystander.
Fine, but I do not want her at this house, Mary Elizabeth.
You know, you could at least pick up around here a little bit before I come home.
Doc says I still can't lift anything heavy.
I didn't ask you to move the furniture, just to clean up a little bit around it. Come on. I think together we could probably get this finished.
Yeah, we can do it. Come on, baby.
It's heavy, but I know. Would you hide my cigarettes?
You started again?
One a day. Like the vitamin. Where are my damn cigarettes?
Figured this would be one place you'd never look.
Very funny.
Not so fast.
You. What do you got back there?
I ain't got nothing, Mr. DeJuicy.
Come on. Come on. Let me see.
Give it here.
What do you mean?
Come here.
See? Told ya.
You listen to me. You stay away from that girl. She's trouble.
Yes, sir. Why'd you do that, girl? Who are you?
Renee Jackson. How come I ain't seen you around here before?
We just moved here from Detroit. What's your name?
Mary Elizabeth O'Brien. Hey, you ever seen a bunch of naked boys? They're all down at the swimming hall. Come on.
Imagine not being able to sit next to your friends on the bus.
Now, this is the girl you marched in a parade with.
Demonstration, not parade. See, her father was very involved in the civil rights movement.
You gonna sit in there all day? Well, roll the window down then. It's gonna get hot.
You can't do this to me!
Hush, do you want the whole neighborhood to hear?
I don't care. You have no right. You can't tell me what to do.
I have every right. I carried you for 9 months and spent 27 hours in labor. By law, your butt is mine for 18 years, and that is why you are not going to this party.
You can't stop me.
Oh, if I have to sit on you, I'll stop you. Davis, just promise me.
He'll never have to sit on me, Mom.
Thank you very much.
Here's go.
It's cold outside. I've got the month of May. I guess you'd say, what can make me my girl? My girl. Talking about my girl.
Okay.
My girl.
I've got Kelly's locked in her room. Davis locked his retainer. And we only have $143 in our checking account. Ooh. Unfortunately, I wrote a check at the grocery store this afternoon for $148.
And the birds in the trees.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
I also sent flowers to Renee and her mother.
Well,
I put your name on the card, too.
I thought you were never going to talk to her again.
Her father died, Collier.
She didn't show up when Bobby died.
I want to see her.
It's a can of worms, Shug.
Well, you know time heals.
Maybe for you. What about her?
I suddenly feel 10 years old again.
I know, it's like a time warp.
Boy, you look beautiful, like something out of a magazine.
Thank you. You look great, too.
You sound different, too. East Coast, I guess. I'm so sorry about your dad.
How you doing?
Okay.
Is your brother here? I didn't see him.
Not right now. How's Collier?
Good. He's been off work. He hurt his back, but he's good. It's the same clock. I remember counting down the minutes to the Patty Duke show. Is there anything I can do?
I should really get back to everyone.
I'd like to come to the service. Your father put up with so much from us. Well, for me.
I hope you will.
I've written about 300 letters to you over the years and thrown them all away. I've really missed you. You want to grab a cup of coffee or something? Maybe do you good to get out of here for a minute. Well, I'll call you.
Your mother told me about the fight, son. Did she tell you I didn't start it?
You can't get into a fight with everyone that calls you a name.
I hate it here. I want to go back to Detroit.
Not everyone's like those boys, Elson. Look at Emmy. She's my best friend.
You think she's your friend, but one day when you turn your back, she'll call you a nigga. I'll get it. How about you, darling? Do you hate it here, too?
Some of it. I don't like having to ride in the back of the bus, Daddy. Makes me feel like I'm not good enough or something.
That's the way they want you to feel. But they're wrong. You're the same as anyone else. The same girl here as you were in Detroit. You can be anything you want to be. Do you understand?
Yes, Daddy.
That's my girl.
Train. I could buy a soda pop with a nickel. Come on. I swear I'd rather die on rock than tell about a secret spot. So cross my heart, I will not tell, cause if I do, I'll go to hell. Okay, listen. Especially designed for the budding young figure, the Pink Angel is made with a soft cup that is fiberfill for the subtle extra touch.
That stupid one with the lace and pink bow?
It's not a bow, it's the Pink Angel, and it's not stupid.
You never wear anything called Pink Angel.
Bet you do.
Bet I don't. I'm never wearing a bra or makeup. I ain't getting married either.
What are you gonna do with me?
I'm gonna be the first girl to play Major League Baseball.
Well, I'm going to stay here, get married to a smart, handsome man, and have 4 children. I can't wait to be a woman.
You can't wait to do everything there is to do, Renee Jackson. You know what the real name for a bra is, don't you?
No.
Booby trap.
How old is Davis?
He's 12. He loves animals, wants to be a veterinarian. And Kelly, believe it or not, is a math genius.
They're beautiful.
Yeah, they got Collier's looks. I just don't know where they got their brains. What?
Nothing, just you as June Cleaver.
How about you, Perry Mason? So,
Tell me about Garrett.
We met on Friday, moved in together on Sunday. That was 3 years ago.
You gonna get married?
It's complicated. Ex-wife, 2 children. We will eventually, but I'm in no rush.
You always wanted kids.
Yeah, well, you know, I do have this career.
Clock's ticking. Want to see something funny?
What's this?
My homework. I've gone back to school. I'm doing a little writing. Now, this is just a rough draft. It's about us as kids chasing fireflies, charm school, Port Dixie. What was the name of that bra you wanted?
The Pink Angel.
Mama, there it is, the Pink Angel.
All right.
Come on.
Oh, yes, it is, sweetheart. We have to see how much it costs.
Do you want to buy that?
Oh, yes, but she'd like to try it on first, see if it fits.
Oh, well, we don't have a colored dressing room. If you want it, you have to buy it.
Mom, I'm probably a what, a 32 double A?
We're going, Renee.
But I'll have to try it on, really.
Yes, sweetheart, you do.
But I want this one.
There are plenty of stores in Birmingham where our business will be welcome. Now, sweetie, let's go.
I don't want to go to another store. Why can't we just buy it?
We are not buying any merchandise from this store. Do you hear me? Now stop complaining this instant.
Please, it'll fit.
Oh, my God. It's her.
Oh, I'll be right with you. Yes?
Do you remember me?
No, I'm afraid I don't.
I was a customer a long time ago.
Well, it's nice to have you back. We have some beautiful camisoles on sale.
Hi, Jude.
Hey. I got a call from school today. I had to go pick up Kelly. She was smoking and cutting class.
Oh, great. Where is she?
Upstairs. You deal with her. If I see her right now, I'm going to kill her.
Sit down. Did you cut class?
Am I allowed to talk? Yes, but I didn't mean to. At lunch, I didn't feel good, so I went into the bathroom and I fell asleep.
Maybe it was those cigarettes you were smoking.
You smoke?
And you see me trying to quit? Why the hell would you want to even start? Listen here. We have got to talk. I don't know how we got so far apart.
I hate my life, okay? I hate it.
I understand
that.
No,
you don't understand that. Do you know what it's like to bring friends home to see your father drinking beer in his underwear?
Boxers, I hope. Kelly, your father hurt his back. He's worked very hard. We've both worked very hard.
For what? For this dump? I hate it here. Leave me alone. Just leave me alone.
Fine. You want to be left alone? You got it. Go to your room right now and stay there the rest of the night.
say we lock her in a room till she turns 30. She didn't mean it, you know. I expect you told your mama you hated her, too.
Mm-hmm. I just thought it'd be different with my own kids. He'd be 24 years old now. You think he'd hate us, too?
Probably just me. Oh, I was thinking, you know, if you want to invite Renee over, well, I guess it's your house, too.
Well, thank you, Connor. I already did.
Yes.
I'll get back to you. I'm Graham Pierce, your father's associate.
Why are all these people here?
Well, most of them are clients.
Clients? Don't they know? I mean...
They know. They wanted to be here.
Excuse me, Mr. Pierce. Will you let us know about the services?
Of course. Miss Cutcliffe, this is Renee, James' daughter.
Your father was the most decent man I ever knew. If it weren't for him, I would have lost my home. Thank you, Mrs. Cutcliffe. I don't know why God takes the good ones.
See, we're all just in a state of shock. Your father and I were just preparing a case to go to trial next week, and I haven't touched anything in his office. It was a big case. Of course, they were all important to your dad.
How many active files did he have?
Over 50.
Well, we'll refer them out to other attorneys.
He didn't even have a retainer on most of them. It was a labor of love.
Well, after the funeral, I'll come back and we'll go through them.
Your father talked about you all the time. I guess you know how much he wanted you to come down here and work with him.
No, he never told me that.
Well, I'll let you be alone now. I'm very glad to meet you. You look like him.
I do?
Yeah. You got his eyes. I'll be right out here if you need anything.
Your parents to let me?
I know. We can go to my Grandma Otis's. Mama says she's a real liberal.
her third husband left her so much money, they had to give her a bank to put it all in. That's the sorriest trick I've ever seen in my life. Takes more than that to scare me.
You ever look in the mirror?
Hi, Mary Elizabeth.
Hey, Collier.
You know, there's a new Elvis movie down at the Majestic, and
call your Aunt Emmy sitting in a tree. K-I-S-S.
Shut up, Tully!
Well, we gotta go, so I'll see you later, Mary Elizabeth.
Hi.
Just sit up.
Collier likes you and me. He's just a stupid boy. Come on, Slowpoke.
Emmy!
One writer to another, what do you think?
She's good. Raw. She needs to learn how to spell, but she's good. Her parents wouldn't let you in their house? Unbelievable.
She had a swing set and a tetherball in the backyard. Sometimes her mother would let us play, but the moment her father came home, I'd have to run out the back gate.
Why didn't you ever tell me about this?
Guess there's a lot I haven't told you about. Garrett, why did you come?
I came because you wanted me to. Because it was important to you.
But it's not important to you, is it? I mean, meeting my family, seeing where I grew up, you don't seem to care about these things.
Are you accusing me of being unsentimental?
No. I just don't know what's important to you.
Us. Being together.
Being a family?
Well, if you and I are a family, then yes. I thought we talked about this.
We did. We did in the beginning. It's just that, I don't know, being home, seeing all my relatives, my old friends, I'm just feeling a little bit empty. What?
I'm really surprised. I thought that you wanted what I wanted. That you wanted what I wanted.
I did.
You did or you do? I think maybe you should talk to the pastor alone. I'm going back to the hotel. I have some papers.
What about dinner with Mary Elizabeth?
I don't want to go.
Why not?
Renee, she's your friend. I have nothing in common
with what? People who are important to me?
I'll see you later.
Alabama, let's hear it for the girl.
Look at that one. She's as ugly as all get out. Grandma, hurry up. You're gonna miss it. Look at Miss Oklahoma. God, she's beautiful.
Okay. I just couldn't get my honey lamb off the phone.
Is your honey lamb coming over later tonight?
That's none of your business, child. But you girls are planning on leaving right after the swimsuit competition, aren't you?
What's that? Can I open it?
Uh-huh. Beautiful. I won it right here in 1922, the Miss Camellia pageant.
Can I try it on?
Well, sure.
Miss Alabama, 1968. Well, now all I gotta do is come up with a talent.
Well, you could always recite a dramatic poem.
Let me try. What's so funny? You, that's what. Renee, you can't be Miss America. Why not? You're colored. There's never been a colored Miss America.
Miss Virginia. Miss Washington.
I hope Miss Texas wins.
She doesn't stand a lick of a chance against Miss North Carolina.
Renee?
Nay!
Actually, I haven't seen the inside of a courtroom in years.
Inside of a plane? Yes. I travel a lot, mostly Europe and Asia.
Have you ever met the president?
No.
But you know, Renee's father met President Kennedy.
Your dad met President Kennedy?
Once. My father worked with Martin Luther King. They had a meeting with him.
Can I be excused?
We're having a conversation, Kelly.
I remember that meeting. Damn near started a riot. Give me another beer, will you, son?
All I remember is how much you wanted to meet Bobby Kennedy. You had such a crush on him.
Can I be excused?
Your mother always said no, Kelly. If you can't say something nice, then don't say anything at all.
This must be pretty boring for you. Mary Elizabeth tells me you love math.
I hate math.
She hates everything.
I hate you, that's for sure.
Please.
What other lies did you tell her?
I told you, shut up.
Collier. Go to your room right now. Go on.
Fine.
Welcome to our happy home. Game's almost on, Shug. Why don't you tell us when dessert's ready? Come on, son.
Sorry.
Don't be silly.
Collier's just out of sorts because he hasn't been working. And
Emmy, it doesn't matter.
It does matter. I wanted so bad to prove you wrong, to show you that my life, my family, it's not perfect, but it's good. My life has not been a mistake.
Is that why you invited me over?
Isn't that why you came over?
That was a long time ago. We both said hurtful things.
You told me to get an abortion, told me I was white trash.
You called me a nigger. You and Collier were 19. I thought you were making a mistake.
Bobby was not a mistake. But hey, he's dead now anyway, so you got your wish.
What?
He was my baby, and I lost him. And you never picked up the damn phone. He was only 5 years old when he drowned, Renee. And those are 5 years that I wouldn't trade for anything, no matter how many doors it closed for me.
I think I'd better go.
Yeah, go ahead and go. Go ahead and run away just like you did before.
I didn't run away. I got the hell out.
I am not white trash.
I never said...
And neither is Collier.
I didn't say that you were. What I said was if you stayed here and you married Collier...
Who the hell are you to judge me? You might be some big shot lawyer, but you're alone. You got no husband, no kids.
And this is what I have to look forward to? Look, we're different people. We've led different lives. Why don't we just let this go, huh?
Yeah, if that's the way you want it.
My father said that our friendship was the hope of the future.
Didn't turn out too bright, did it?
Daddy, what happened?
lied to me, Daddy. You told me we were all the same. You told me I could be anything I wanted to be. That's not true.
I never lie to you, and I never will.
ME says there's no such thing as a color, Miss America.
Okay, come on, sit up.
Let your daddy talk to you. There you go.
That's a big girl. Your friend told you the truth. No Negro woman has ever won Miss America. But that doesn't mean it's right. Nor does it mean it's not going to change. It's not going to be easy. You know, when I told my father I wanted to be a lawyer, he just shook his head and said he had never met a colored lawyer. Didn't think he ever would. He died the year I started law school.
I don't know if I want to be Miss America, Daddy, but I want to be able to try.
Then don't be afraid. That's where it all starts. People are afraid of things they don't know or people they haven't met. And fear and ignorance breed what?
Prejudice.
That's my girl.
Semi-ignorant?
No, honey. She's just young.
I just want to be like everybody else.
I know, baby. I know. I know you do. I know you do.
I know it sounds like a cliche, but your father would have loved the funeral. And these grounds. It's incredible what people spend these days on the funeral.
Garrett, I want to stay.
I knew it. I knew it.
You couldn't, because I didn't know it until this moment.
You have so many bad memories here.
Yeah, I do. This is my home.
No. It's your past.
And I feel like I've been running away from it all these years. From my father, from his work, my friends, my family. I saw some of the faces of the people that my father helped. He cared about them. He made a difference in their lives. I want to change my life, Garrett.
Renee, stop and think about this. All right? Listen, think about what you're doing. Think about what you're throwing away. You spent the past 15 years working nonstop to become one of the most highly paid and most prominent attorneys in Washington. Now, for a black woman, for any woman, that's an incredible achievement. And now you're going to throw it all away.
You don't understand.
And what about us? You willing to throw all that away, too?
No. I love you, Garrett. But I want more. And I was hoping that you'd want to change, too. There's a university right here.
Baby, that's not gonna happen.
Okay. It's only a 2-hour flight from here to Washington.
And how many times are you gonna take that trip before you realize it's still too far?
About Louisa Sims, she up and ran off with her first cousin last night.
Mama says she must have been in a hurry. That means she's gonna have a baby. Daddy said it ain't natural with your first cousin and all. The baby's gonna have a pointed head and webbed feet.
Miss North Carolina one. She was real pretty. She didn't sing half as good as you. I don't want it anymore. Then I don't eat. That's a good outfit. You might want to stand across the street.
I may have just made the biggest mistake of my life. I just dropped Garrett off at the airport.
You're not going back with him?
I should have called you when Bobby died.
It's okay.
No, it's not. I spend every day of my life talking, arguing, manipulating language, but when I really need the words, I don't know where to find them.
What you want to do? We could go down to Old Man the Juicy's and steal some smokes.
Emmy, you know those things always get you into trouble.
Hey, I know. There's a double feature at the Majestic. We could go there.
I don't want to go there.
I'll have to sit in the balcony.
So what? I'll sit with you.
Come on.
Think Collier will be there?
So what if he is? He's just this stupid boy.
Come on.